So yesterday we did a demonstration video showing counting mites in dead-out honeybees from packages. Today we're going to revisit that so I can demonstrate the procedure and we can prove that the method I used to count the mites actually will work with mites present, because the issue yesterday was no mites showed up in the dead bee wash and count. So now we want to make sure and test the method. Repeatability. That's the way to do that. So I have a bottom board tray that comes from a flow hive too, and there is a Varroa destructor mite. There's another Varroa destructor mite. So if we have a source where we know that there are mites, it allows us to prove the method for rinsing and finding them. So here they are. I pre-washed in the bottom here with some Dawn soap, and I'm using paper coffee filters. The procedure is identical to what we did yesterday. People questioned whether or not this sieve, this screen, was too fine to allow mites to go through. So I thought the best way to demonstrate that that works is to do it with a known mite source. So here we go. We've got just soap and water here, dumping out through the screen, just as we did when we're counting the mites on the bees, only this is, of course, account of the material that goes through the screen on the bottom board of a flow hive too. Gonna do another rinse here, make sure we don't leave anything behind. Pour it right through the screen again. We can see that the screen does collect bits and pieces as it does before. That's what we wanted to. The things that we want to end up having to count or look at on the coffee filter, we want to deal with just the tiniest pieces. But I'm going to take it through the whole thing. Again, make sure that the water level in your colander does not rise above that 10-inch paper coffee filter. So I'm going to take a close look here at the screen and see, just by chance, if there are any Varroa destructor mites still clinging on there, and I do not see any. And this is considered a fine screen stainless steel mesh. And I think we did not stop any Varroa destructor mites from going through it, but we're going to follow through the whole process and you're going to get to look at mites to see and maybe help, for those who are just beginning, identify mites when compared to other bits and pieces that you may find on the bottom board or the removable tray of your beehive. Now, one thing we have to do too is run lots of fresh water through here, because we want to defeat those soapy suds. They would compete and, of course, conflict with our desire to see the mites. So we don't want to hide any mites in bubbles. So we let that drain out, gets to the bottom there, and now we're going to follow our procedure. Just as before, we have a 10-inch Corel plate that's white, because the white background is going to provide us with the highest contrast for viewing mites. And we just pull up the paper filter here. These things are super cheap, by the way. You get them by the 100 packs at big box stores. I just spread it out there. Again, it's a 10-inch plate. Use a white one if you can. It's Corel. For those of you who are concerned, no, we don't eat off of it. Now look, you can clearly see that is a Varroa destructor mite dead center. So this will help those who are beginners looking at the bits and pieces that are on a bottom board or wherever you find them. When you evaluate them on a high contrast background like this, you can see that those are mites. And notice this mite, upside down, had its feet chewed off. What kind of hive did that come from? What colony? Well, they're bee weaver bees, and they came through winter just fine, so this is not a dead out. Also, this does not count as a Varroa mite count method. It just proves that there were mites in the hive. It does not prove that they're at a level that would require treatment. That kind of mite count comes from live bees. And this, of course, is just collecting the detritus that happens at the bottom of the hive over a period of several months, by the way. That's a Varroa destructor mite in the middle, a little high and to the left there. That is not a Varroa destructor mite. How many mites do you see in this picture? I'll give you a second to point them out. There are 5 mites in that picture. Some are upside down, some are right side up. Their little feet are damaged. I know you feel bad for them. Here are 2 more mites. Where do you see them? That's right. Right there and right there. The more you look at, the more mites you see, the quicker you'll spot them. Now keep in mind, you might need a magnifying glass, because I'm showing them to you really close on your screen. So here's what they look like, normal viewing distance, and you can still, once you know what the mites look like, you can spot them. Varroa destructor mites are the single most damaging pest to honeybees. That's how you look for them. So you need a magnifying glass, some Dawn dish soap, or any other soap really, paper, coffee filters, a nice big colander, and then a screening sieve that you can put your dead bees on. Also, when you have a dead out in your hives or you're scraping landing boards, go ahead and scoop those bees right into a jar or something and use this process to see if they might have had Varroa destructor mites on them. It does dislodge them and you get informed. Thanks for watching, and I hope this satisfied those who are concerned about the screen in that sieve being too fine to pass the mites through. Have a great day.